Ladies and gentlemen, please let us welcome His Excellency Dr. Matar Al Neyadi, Undersecretary of the Ministry of Energy of the United Arab Emirates.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Your Excellency, distinguished guest, my dear student, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to start by thanking the International Center for the Energy and the Climate of the Sabah University for inviting me to speak at this important forum in one of the most beautiful cities in the world, Istanbul. I'm especially glad to be invited in what is a crucial year for the energy sectors and for the sustainability, for sustainable energy policy making. Last year, the outcome of the Paris COP21 set the long-term priorities for 188 countries around the world in the area of clean energy, energy efficiency, and sustainability. It marked a decisive change of momentum. It changed the pact in a long effort to control emission and to implement sustainable energy strategy across the world. Starting in 2016, countries around the world must ensure that the road toward clean energy, energy efficiency, and sustainability is constructed securely, with a reasonable energy policy making and with a smooth transition to the energy industry. This new momentum created by COP21 has set a new collaboration between countries, public and private partnership. As this forum correctly mentioned, the next step is for us as a stakeholder of the energy industry to find out what are the implications of our industry. And let me here turn to the United Arab Emirates' experience in this regard. In the case of the UAE, the nation has taken a leading role in implementing a sustainable energy transformation. Since 2007, the country has made a great progress in diversifying its energy portfolio and increasing energy efficiency. We believe that long-term energy policymaking and the support of the stakeholder of the energy industry, from government leadership to energy company, and the engagement of the UAE population is the key to success of the implementation of the energy sectors. As we all believe that no country can address climate change on its own, the UAE believes that cooperation with other nations around the world is crucial to meet the energy-related demand of the Conference of the Paris COP21 goal for limiting global warming by 2050 and to deliver this transition to a cleaner future in this new era of collaboration. We recently concluded a successful clean energy ministerial SIM7 and the Mission Innovation Ministerial meeting in San Francisco, and we're encouraged to witness that the strength of the momentum that COP21 is still strong. The SIM represents 90% of the global clean energy investment and 75% of greenhouse gas emission. Together with the private sectors, the platform has worked to accelerate the delivery of a clean energy around the world since 2010. It has successfully committed to continue to improve the competitiveness of a clean energy technology, decarbonize the power sector, increase the access of the private sector to renewable energy and improving energy management. Our contribution to key international platforms such as Clean Energy Ministerial is crucial, to ensure that we engage with the international community in this effort. We also believe SIM is a unique platform to make the private sector participant through the creation of innovation collaboration. At the conclusion of the first ministerial meeting of the Mission Innovation Initiative, the World Energy and Business Leader announced key action to accelerate the global deployment of technology. 21 countries committed to double budget in clean energy research and development, which today reach $15 billion every year. Together, the public and private sector represented more than 60 global companies committed to increase innovation in technology and R&D. The United Arab Emirates welcomed this renewed momentum to create a green economy where clean energy can have a greater role in powering the growth of the nation and where our national resource can be used more efficiently. In 2007, the UAE took the pioneer role to launch a series of initiatives in the field of energy that have proven to be crucial in setting the nation on the right path to clean energy, energy sustainability, and the creation of a green economy. To achieve our vision to create a sustainable infrastructure and a green energy, the UAE focused on three key areas. The first one is the delivery of a clean energy strategy, focusing particularly on the development of a solar energy and an international recognized peaceful nuclear energy program. This investment has placed the UAE on the right track to exceed 24% of a clean energy by 2021 from only 1% achieved last year. The second area is the launch of energy efficiency program through the drive to reduce energy demand and increase the energy productivity of the UAE through ambitious demand-side management strategy. Over the last year, we have successfully launched local energy efficiency initiatives targeting to encourage a reduction of energy demand to both household and business. We are also working on a federal level to reduce energy consumption of more than 4,000 federal buildings and achieve saving of up to 30% of both electricity and water consumption. The UAE has also made a significant effort in green building code and regulation. The result is that 73% of the new building complying with the green code and standard. This initiative are only some example in the strategic move to increase energy efficiency in the UAE. The third area to focus on is the creation of modern infrastructure and promoting innovation in the energy sector and the new collaboration opportunity between the private and public sector. The contribution of the UAE to sustainability and clean energy is also important for the entire Middle East region. The Middle East is the fifth region in the world in terms of growth of energy demand. The IEA estimates that the Middle East will require more than 5 million tons of oil equivalent to energy demand from here until 2014. Energy plays a crucial role in supporting economic growth, and so countries in the Middle East can turn to the UAE to power this growth in a sustainable manner. The UAE is confident that the future of the energy sector is bigger, is bright, and that many opportunities lie ahead if we collaborate and share our lesson together. We will continue to work toward this goal and welcome any opportunity to open our door to new innovation cooperation. I look forward to the discussion of this important forum and to debating with you the future of the energy sector in a sustainable future. Thank you.